Have you moved with pets? There's always something new to learn when it comes to our furry family members. On this episode, I'm sharing a few resources to help make your military move with pets easier. Welcome to Mil Spouse Matters, the podcast dedicated to encouraging military spouses. I'm your host, Jen McDonald, and I was a military spouse for nearly 30 years until my husband's retirement. I'm now the mom of 4 young adults, including 1 active duty son. I also wrote the book, You Are Not Alone, Encouragement for the Heart of a Military Spouse. Through my experiences, I came to believe that we're only stronger together. Whatever life is throwing your way as a military spouse, let's talk about it. Have you made a military move with pets? Then you know all the problems that can arise. Moving with pets adds an extra layer of stress or maybe adventure, especially when you're moving overseas. Aside from all the paperwork and hoops you have to jump through to get your pet in and out of different countries and even states, there's the actual travel itself. When we were moving back from Germany, our flight out of Frankfurt was delayed, and as we ran to catch our next flight, the door to the jet bridge was shut just as we ran up. We were not able to book a flight until the next day. So while Steve, my husband, wrangled hotel and flight arrangements for us and our 4 kids, I was trying to determine where our dog Toby was because he had been on that flight and we didn't know, had he already been loaded onto the flight we had just missed? Was he sitting in a storage facility somewhere? Nobody could seem to tell us anything. My 2 middle schoolers were both in tears at that point, and I almost was too, to be honest. Finally, we decided to walk down to the lost baggage area on the off chance that he might be there. And as I walked up to the desk, I suddenly heard a soft whine behind me. I'd walked right past his crate. Wagging crazily, Toby heard our voices and nearly jumped out of his crate. We were so relieved. So whether or not you've had a great experience or bad experience moving your pets, today I wanted to share with you some resources that you just might not know about. There are so many amazing resources and organizations supporting military families on the move as they move with their pets. Calling all pet owners, are you looking for a natural solution to help calm your furry friend? Look no further than Well-Loved Calming Chews for Dogs. With all natural and holistic ingredients, their customers rave about the hours of calming relief these delicious soft chews provide for their dogs. Made in the USA and veterinarian approved, you can trust the quality and effectiveness of Well-Loved Calming Chews. Whether it's a long flight with your pet or the upcoming 4th of July celebrations, these chews can help ease anxiety and stress in most dogs within 30 to 60 minutes. Say goodbye to restless nights and nervous behavior. It's time for a calmer and happier pup. What sets Well-Loved Calming Chews apart is not only their calming effects, but also their irresistible taste. Dogs love the delicious, soft chews, making it a breeze to give them the relief they deserve. If your pet is affected by the 4th of July fireworks or summer thunderstorms, prepare now. Well-Loved Calming Chews for Dogs are the solution you've been searching for. And don't miss out on upcoming Prime Day deals on Amazon July 11th and 12th. You can also save with their subscribe and save options or by buying 2 or more of selected items. Visit the link in the show notes to find out more and order your Well-Loved Calming Chews for Dogs today. So there are so many helpful resources for military families moving with pets, ranging from pet relocation grants to pet foster care. Of course, you'll need to ensure that your pet's health certificate, immunizations, and other paperwork are all completed for the country or state you're relocating to. And for that, I highly recommend researching the base you're heading to, especially overseas, to get the most updated information because it's always changing. I always found that the military veterinarians were so helpful and knowledgeable when it came to specifics about pet vaccinations and paperwork. If you're moving overseas, make this appointment ASAP. Because some countries and even states like Hawaii have strict quarantines in place to control rabies and other diseases. But aside from the official requirements, a military family can find themselves in some interesting situations. So let's talk about a few resources to make your military move with pets easier. Have you heard of the Air Mobility Command, AMC, Patriot Express flights? You might be eligible to ship your pet via military transport. There are limited spaces for pets on AMC flights for overseas PCS travel, and those go out of the Baltimore, Washington International or Seattle, Tacoma International airports, and a limit of 2 pets per family applies. They have similar breed restrictions as commercial airlines do. And while it is much less expensive than flying commercially, those spots are very limited. So it's recommended to contact your local transportation office as early as possible if you're thinking of doing that. Some current requirements include you must be in PCS status, pet spaces are booked on a first-come, first-served basis, orders aren't required at the time of booking, pet owners must accompany their pets on the flight and pay all expenses. So you can get more information about the Patriot Express, including kennel size and weight requirements, at the AMC pet travel page. I will link to all of the places that I'm mentioning and resources in the show notes. Now, pet transport companies are another option. If you type pet relocation into Google, you're going to come up with a multitude of companies. So how do you know who to trust? Well, we'll talk about that in just a second. But what a pet transport company does is handle all the details of shipping your pet overseas or even transportation domestically, including quarantine and immunization paperwork you're required to file, travel and flight arrangements, any needed documents, and pickup and delivery to and from the airport. So that's a lot. And they're not cheap. But not all companies are equal. You can avoid a shady company or scam artist by finding professional pet shippers that are already screened through the International Pet and Travel Association, IPATA. They also cover common questions about transporting pets, and they have a members-only section with country profiles, directory, training resources, and more. So check that out. Did you know about military pet relocation grants? Since the cost of shipping a cat or dog in the cargo area of a plane can run anywhere from about $200 to $1,000, it just depends on the pet size. Other possible costs include vet screening. Sometimes you have to buy a new kennel to have an approved kennel for that airline, quarantine fees, custom clearance. It can get expensive to move with a pet. So there are several companies and nonprofits that are working to alleviate this hardship for military families who want to keep their pets. So a few of them are the Dogs on Deployment Rich Setzer Memorial Grant Fund. Now, remember, I am just listing these for your information. If the guidance has changed or they've changed what they do, I'm just trying to help you find some resources. So just do your research yourself as well. But this organization offers financial assistance for certain pet expenses for military members, usually E6 or below. Are you looking for a fun and engaging way to bond with your family during those long trips or military moves? Look no further than Do You Really Know Your Family, the ultimate family card game. Whether you're traveling across the country or stationed in a new location, this game is the perfect companion to creating unforgettable family moments. It's time to turn those hours on the road or in temporary housing into quality time filled with laughter and connection. Laugh, learn, and bond as you answer fun questions about each other, sparking interesting conversations that bring your family closer than ever before. Create hilarious memories as you compete and perform silly challenges. It's the game that guarantees nonstop laughter and unforgettable moments. Do You Really Know Your Family is super easy to learn and play. It's perfect for families with kids ages 8 and up, teens, and adults. Everyone can join in on the fun. So, whether you're on the move, stationed overseas, or having a family game night at home, Do You Really Know Your Family is the perfect game to strengthen your family bonds and create lasting memories. Visit the link in the show notes to bring Do You Really Know Your Family home and experience the ultimate laughter-filled, knowledge-packed family game night. Operation Military Pets from the SPCA gives financial assistance to offset pet relocation costs. Operation We Are Here is not a pet program, but they have a very big list, pretty comprehensive, of pet resources for military and veteran families that you can do a search and take a look. So many things from foster care to relocation grants. Operation Roger is kind of a fun one. That is a trucker's pet transport. They have regional and long-haul truckers who volunteer to transport pets in need. It is a nonprofit organization, so you would need to contact them to see if you would be able to qualify for their program. Do you know about pet reimbursements from the government? The Department of Defense, as of January 1st, 2024, says that military service members going through a PCS within the continental U.S. can be reimbursed up to $550 for one household pet, either cat or dog, or up to $2,000 for moves to or from a location outside the continental United States that cover costs related to the transportation of a pet. That is huge because in the past, service members have paid out of pocket to transport pets when assigned to a new duty station, and that has been a huge financial burden. So the policy reduces that financial burden and recognizes the important role a pet plays in a military family's household. There's also pet foster care for military families. When faced with a short notice overseas move or deployment, some military families must make the decision to leave a pet behind temporarily. For example, when our family moved to Hawaii, we had really short notice orders. And at that time, you either had to have completed their quarantine beforehand, or they would have to go into a kennel for several months after we got there. So we decided to go ahead and start the quarantine process, but have my dog stay with my sister. And then she flew out with him later. But if you don't have friends or family members able to help you out, take a look at some organizations that have a mission of providing temporary homes for pets of military members going through transitions. Their goal is to reunite families and help prevent the occurrence of abandoned animals. So every agency has a different option and requirement, so make sure to check them out. The American Humane Society recommends several shelters and private groups like Dogs on Deployment, Military Pets Foster Project, and Pact for Animals who can help place pets in foster homes temporarily. You can sometimes also get assistance from your local base command. Pact for Animals is a group that I have been following on Instagram, and they are always posting animals that are in need of foster homes and great stories of dogs and cats reunited with their owners. And they're doing a lot of great work. They are a 501c3 nonprofit providing foster care for the pets of military service members on deployment and individuals in medical crisis. Another organization called Guardian Angels for Soldiers Pet helps with out-of-country PCS, including Hawaii, where they're unable to take their pets with them due to airline restrictions. Like weather-related, there are some airlines that will not allow you to bring certain breeds on a flight, or regulations related to vaccinations and quarantine requirements. They help support foster terms of between 3 to 6 months. They also do some other work with wounded warriors, homeless veterans, and deployments. So take a look at Guardian Angels for Soldiers Pet. You might even find help through your state humane society for finding foster care for your pet if you hit that point of need. There are also some resources for alternative travel plans where if your PCS falls during the time of year wherein pet travel in a plane cargo is limited due to extreme temperatures, you might have some alternatives. You can send your pet on a cargo flight. In fact, Delta Airlines has year-round shipment of animals, and even American Airlines has a pet embark program. Amtrak, if you're traveling in-country, now allows smaller animals to be transported for a pretty minimal fee. The travel time can only be 7 hours total, and weight and breed restrictions do apply. So I hope that you found some new useful information in this episode. I will be doing some of these quick tips episodes over the rest of the summer, and then we'll be heading into our normal schedule of longer shows and more interviews in the fall. So I hope this is helpful to you. And if you're in the midst of a PCS, I hope that it's going great and that you are settling in. Or if you're in the middle of it, I wish you all the best as you move. And remember, no matter where in the world this finds you, you are brave, you are strong, and you've got this. I'll talk to you next time. Hey, friends. If you enjoyed this episode, be sure to visit my site to find even more resources for your military life, including a comprehensive list of PCS Move resources, resources for military kids, and military spouse resources, as well as my book, You're Not Alone, Encouragement for the Heart of a Military Spouse, a book study guide, and a deployment devotional, all on my site at jen-mcdonald.com. Thanks for listening to the MilSpouse Matters podcast. Connect with me at MilSpouseMatters.com or on social media as @MilSpouseMatters. You can find my book, You Are Not Alone, Encouragement for the Heart of a Military Spouse, on Amazon and other booksellers. Love the show? Please leave a 5-star review in whatever podcast player you're listening, and then share it with someone else who could use it too. Until next time, have a great week.